Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you our 2010 Derby car. We just picked it up last night. It's a 1976 Thunderbird. Bought it from the Ohio and Michigan border, where it was located at. Very clean car, very solid car. Looking forward to building this one. It's a ready strip for us, which is a good thing, because I don't have as much time this year to build the car. As you can see, all the windows are already removed out of it. There's a whole bunch of extra stuff we got with the car. All kinds of deals here. It's got the front bumper in there. We have two drive shafts in here, some sheet metal, two Ford radiators that are perfectly fine. There's the driver's seat, carpet. We got some extra seat bars that we can use. But the dashboard's removed out of this car already. Everything is taken out. So it's ready for our stuff to be put in. It's the winter time though, hasn't snowed yet. Still pretty cold out. Early in the morning today, we still have the car loaded on the trailer and we're gonna take it and store it for winter. It's gonna go with my other car, the green Lincoln. So both of those will be ready when spring comes. We can take them out and start working on them. So I'll give you guys an overview of the car here, show you what we have to work with. The most rustiest thing on this car is the back bumper. That's it. There's a rust hole there. And it's really rusted out right here. So we're not sure if we're going to use this back bumper or not. We're going to take it off and just see how it is when we look at it. The back of this car, all clean besides that. Frame is amazing under here. I'll see if I can get a shot of it. There's the frame on this car. Up there is where the gas tank used to be. It has a 9-inch bolt and axle rear end. So we're gonna hang on to that afterwards. Very clean otherwise. I'll pop the trunk, show you what's inside of here. Got all kinds of goodies with this car. There's part of a motor sitting in the trunk. This is off of a 89 Crown Vic motor, the top half to it. They took it off. Here's all the fuel injection parts from that motor. There is a motor inside of this car right now that is supposedly running. It just needs hooked up. It's laying inside the engine compartment. It's not bolted down in there or anything, just sitting. It ran when it was in the 89 Vic. Ran strong, they said. They converted it over to carb from fuel injection. So these are all the fuel injection parts laying in here. Some of these I might keep. There's a Ford solenoid right there. We'll take that apart and see if that's still good. That'll be a good spare to have. But otherwise, check out the trunk. It's really rust-free. As you can see, nothing is rusted out in here. There's the drive shaft. You can see all the way inside the car. Very nice car. Continuing up here, show you the inside. There's the doors, real thick doors. Like I said, this is from 1976, so it's a good car. The doors even have the inner braces built into them. You can see right there, that's a thick piece of metal. That will definitely keep our doors from folding in as quick, like our Lincoln did on the doors. You saw they shoved way in, because this is also another two-door car. So with, like you have a problem with any two doors, you always have to protect the doors. That is a big new weakness of them. There's the driver's seat. It has to get bolted back to the floor. We're gonna keep it out while we work on the car. It'll be much easier, more room. There's the front bumper. I've heard good stuff and bad stuff about front bumpers off of Thunderbirds. So I'm gonna do some research on them, see if they're decent or not. We'll take it out and eye it up. It looks pretty much rust-free though. Very thick bumper. You just have to make sure it folds right when we use it. We've got a free carpet square, so more stuff to lay on the ground when we're working underneath the car. And I can't show you under the hood because we have the car strapped down to the trailer and the hood is all latched down right now and tightened down. So I can't show you the motor that's in there right now. You can see part of it through the firewall here. It's sitting back in there. Like I said, it's just laying in there loose. But that is a Ford V8 302 motor. Fuel injection converted to carb. It runs. It's the same motor that I have already, so we'll probably keep it for parts or just keep it as a spare motor. If ours ever dies, we have another one right away to put in it. It's got a fan, nice carb, distributor, alternator, all that stuff's ready there. So that's cool. Got a backup now. It's a good thing to have. Four rims with this car. I'm not sure if the rims on this car are the Ford big hold center rims or the small hold center rims. We'll have to measure it and see. All of my rims I currently have with my mud tires are the small sized holes. So if they won't fit on this, we'll just take the torch and we'll cut them bigger. But hopefully they're the same size as this, so nothing needs changed. Pretty sweet. But both doors still open and close. That makes it easier to work on the car. I'll show you the front frame here. See if you can see any of it down in there. It's very solid still. Has no rust problem like our Lincoln does. The Lincoln has a rust hole right along here that's not here on this car. As far as I'm aware, there's no holes rusted in this frame at all. Cross member might need some work. We will look into it, see if we want to weld it on stronger. The fenders on this car right now aren't bolted down. You can see they're loose. The guys that previously had this car, they had the fenders all off when they were putting the motor in it. And then they just bolted them on real quick so they could sell the car. So I'm thinking we might take the fenders off this car, take the hood, everything off, and when we move motors to put my motor in it, we'll go ahead and have it all cleared out so it's easier to get to. Once my motor's in it, we'll put the fenders back on. That'll be pretty sweet. It's a big metal, thick, heavy-duty hood. No worries there. The bumper shocks for this car, since it's a 70s car, is the side I-beam style, which is different than the 80s cars. The 80s have a cylinder tube like this, it's a circle, that slides in and out of the frame. This one here, here's the frame of the car, right here. This here is actually the bumper shock attached to the frame. So the previous owners, they already welded it, you can see here. We'll probably add some more to it to make sure the bumper shock is tight to the frame. I'll have to check on our rules to see what we're allowed to do with that so we don't go too far into it. These bumper shocks will get collapsed. We're just going to cut the weld they did here and shove these all the way in. So that'll be running flush up there. That'll make this bumper real close to the front of the car. The closer you can get your front bumper to the car, the stronger it'll be. It's like a lever. If it sticks out farther, it's going to bend easier. So bring it in as close as you can. But yeah, there's the new car. It's going to be a fun ride. We're going to store it now. I'll show you guys that. And then when spring break comes for me in college, we're going to start working on these cars. Take everything out and swap things. Lots of good stuff to come. Everybody look forward to that.